हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू हिस्ट्री क्लास। सो चैप्टर नंबर 2, द अर्लीस्ट सोसाइटीज, क्लास 5, पार्ट 3। इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट पैलियोलिथिक एज। इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी हैव लर्नड life of the early humans. We know that. So how it is that life of early humans? Early humans are hunter-gatherers. So they move from place to place. Some three reasons are there. They moved, means they wandered place to place. So first thing is they search for food and shelter. So first thing is they search animals because they needed food and also they needed skin. So next thing is second thing is to search plants and trees. They need fruits and also they search trees. They lied on tree tops. And third reason is they to search of water. They searched rivers, lakes, streams. They searched to drink water. And these three reasons, they venture one place to other place. And previous class also we have learnt Stone Age. That is phases of Stone Age. The early man was used stones. They are making tools like weapons, so he was used the stone. So that period is we call that Stone Age. That Stone Age is divided into three categories. So one is Paleolithic period, means Paleolithic, and second is Mesolithic, and third is Neolithic. So these Paleolithic, Mesolithic and Neolithic, these are the Greek words. So Paleolithic we calling that old age, old stone age. Mesolithic is middle stone age and Neolithic is new stone age. Paleolithic age, it begins 600,000 BCE to 10,000 BCE and Mesolithic age begins 10,000 BCE to 8,000 BCE. And Neolithic age, it begins at 8000 BCE to 4000 BCE. So these all we have learnt in previous class. In today's topic, today's class, Paleolithic age. See here, Paleolithic age, or that is old age. We call that old age. See here, the early humans, we know that in previous class we have learned that the earth was formed about 4600 million years ago. The life was started in that earth around 3500 years ago. And afterwards, some limited plants and animals appeared on the screen about millennia. Millennia means what? Thousands of years. After the thousands of years, the plants and animals are appeared on the earth. And next, some early men, some humans are appeared on the earth. That humans are we called that Pleistocene humans or early Pleistocene period, the humans appeared on the earth. So that humans we call that ape-like creatures. Means that early humans are ape-like creatures. Ape-like creatures means their ape-like creatures are hominids. We call that hominids. Hominids means what? They could not walk properly. They could not walk, stand properly. They move from place to place. They search for food and hunting the animals. They move from one place to other place, but they are hominids. And slowly, we have seen that gradually changes in their body. They changed fingers. Their fingers are flexible. Their brain case were larger. Jaws were smaller. So that like peoples we call that Homo erectus peoples. Homo erectus peoples are traveled long distances. And afterwards that early man's was improved, developed here. And nowadays we are saying modern day people. So in modern day people, like we all coming in there, so call them Homo sapiens. Okay, but here peoples are changed in Paleolithic age. In Paleolithic age, some early humans are used, means early humans are called them Quartzite humans. See here, Quartzite humans. Quartzite humans. Okay. So why we call them quartzite humans? So quartzite. What's the meaning of quartzite? Quartzite means it is a hard stone, hard surface of stone. Hard stone. So like by example, see here, these are the stones. Okay, see here. So these stones are here hard surfaces. See here. So these stones are hard surfaces. The Pleistocene period, some humans we call them quartzite human. So these quartzite human uses this like stones. It is the quartzite stone. Okay, quartzite means it is the hard surface. So surface. Okay, it is a hard surface. And so he was using these stones by tools, like a tools. Okay, so like this stone was used by hunting. Okay, and some Paleolithic period is divided into in three categories. Paleolithic period is divided into three categories. See here, one is they here, lower Paleolithic. See here, one by one I am explaining here. So first ones you see here, lower Paleolithic. See, lower Paleolithic. Second one, middle Paleolithic. Middle Paleolithic. And third one, upper Paleolithic. Upper Paleolithic. Okay, the Paleolithic age or old age divided into three categories. One is lower Paleolithic, second is middle Paleolithic, and third is upper Paleolithic. In lower Paleolithic, the humans are uses hand axes. Hand axes. Clubbers. And choppers. So this like tools the early humans was used in lower Paleolithic period. Some lower Paleolithic sites are there. Lower Paleolithic sites are there. See here. Sohan Valley in Punjab. Sohan Valley in Punjab. Next, Belen Valley in Mirzapur. Belen Valley in Mirzapur. And Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh. So these all sites we have seen that lower Paleolithic age. Lower Paleolithic age, here early humans are used hand axes, cleavers, choppers. So these like tools used early humans in lower Paleolithic period. So lower Paleolithic sites are there here, Sohan Valley in Punjab, Belan Valley in Mirzapur and Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so next you see here, it is about lower Paleolithic, and second is the middle Paleolithic age. See here, second one, middle Paleolithic period. In middle Paleolithic period, the humans are uses here scrapers. So for flaking. So middle Paleolithic peoples are used here scrapers. Scrapers means what? It is a drag or pull. So it is taking drag or pull. Afterwards it's flaking the tool. So this like tools used in Paleolithic period. Okay, some Paleolithic period, some sites are there here. See here, sites like middle Paleolithic. So first one is Sohan Valley. Sohan Valley, and next is bank of river Narmada. Narmada, and next Tungabhadra River. Tungabhadra River. So these all sites we have found here middle Paleolithic sites. Means in these sites we have found middle Paleolithic tools. And third one is there here upper Paleolithic. Third one, upper Paleolithic. Upper Paleolithic period, the early humans are used buildings and blades. Buildings and blades. Buildings. So buildings means what? It's a handheld tool. Burins means what? It's a handheld tool. And blades means these are sharpening. Some tools are sharpening. So these like tools are early peoples are used upper Paleolithic period. Some upper Paleolithic sites are there here. See here. Bhopal. Okay, Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh, and some parts of Karnataka and Chota Nagpur. Chota Nagpur Plateau. Plateau. Okay, these all sites, so we have found upper Paleolithic tools. Okay, so and see here, Paleolithic age. Paleolithic age, peoples here used quartzite. Peoples call them here quartzite peoples. Because why we call them quartzite peoples? The use of quartzite stones by tools, like a tools they are using that. So we call them quartzite means quartzite humans. And this Paleolithic age is divided into three categories. That three categories are there: lower Paleolithic age, upper Paleolithic age, and middle Paleolithic age and upper Paleolithic age. So next I am continuing here. Stone tools of early humans. Paleolithic age is completed here. So stone tools stone tools of early humans, So there are three types of them here. Stone tools of early humans. We know that numerous of stones, they are littered. Numerous of stones, they have littered from the Paleolithic period. Litter means what? Scatter. Scattering. You know that in science. Scattering means what? Some stones, some pieces of stones, it move from place to place by wind, by air. Okay? So this like, so these are littered from these stones in Paleolithic age. So some in these early humans prepared for these tools here, like these are the stone tools. So early humans use these stones like, so he was flaking these stones. Flaking means what? It giving the shapes of this stone. Okay, means which part extra is there here? Flaking that. Flaking means what? Cutting the edges that. So it's shaping or designing the tools. Okay, and see here, some three categories are there in stone tools. Okay, that categories are see here. So first one is core tool. First one is core tools. Second one is flake tools. Flake tools. And third one is blade tools. Okay, students. See here, core tools. Core means what? Stone. Core means what? Stone. Stone tools. So first thing is here, stone tools, these are pounding and crushing. Pounding and crushing means what? These stones hit to many times. So this like hit to many times. Hit to the earth surface in many times. Afterwards it breaking that. Okay, and they are making like using that like tools as a tools. Okay, it is about core tools. In core tools, these are approaching that means what? Pounding. Pounding means, so it is a something tools to hitting to the other place. Hitting to the other place. And next one is flake tool. Flake tool was designed. It by flake tools are designed by that tools, designing that tools means flaking the, flaking means what? Cutting the edges of that stone. And blade tool means it that sharpening the tools. Blade tools are sharpening edges of that tools. Okay, so means these are slicing or engraving, means these are sharpening the point of the top part. So these are the blade tools. See here, core tools, flake tools, blade tools. These are stone tools in early humans. Okay, students, here completing part 3. I hope you all are understood in today's topic. So what you have learned today's topic? You have learned about Paleolithic period, means Paleolithic age or old age. In that Paleolithic age, there are in three categories. Lower Paleolithic age, middle Paleolithic age and upper Paleolithic age. So this like these three age, means Paleolithic ages you have learnt in today's class. Also you have learnt in today's class that stone tools of early humans. So that is core tools, flake tools and blade tools. About these three, so you have learnt in today's class. So these all, I hope you all are understood in today's class. So you write it, correct points on your notebook and you write good handwriting. Neatly you should be right there. Okay? See here, your today's class completed here. And next class I am continuing in next session. Thank you.